I will solve three LeetCode problems today, two medium and one hard. The first problem is queens that can attack the king, where we're given a chessboard, some queens, one king, and we need to find those queens that can attack this king. But like we see here, if there is a queen that cannot directly attack a king because there's something in between, then we don't want to say that this one can attack. A queen can attack in 8 directions, it can go as far as it wants, but it cannot jump over everything. So one solution would be for every queen to iterate over those 8 directions, and in each direction just try to go through those cells that can be attacked in this direction till we hit a wall or another thing, a queen or a king. If it's a king, then we should print this queen. Well, we should add it to vector of things that we return. Can we do something smarter than doing that for every queen? Turns out that yes, we can, because we are just interested in those that hit a king. So instead of going what I said for every queen, I will do that for a king. For a king, I will iterate over directions in which queen can attack, and in each direction, I will just go through those cells, and the first queen in that direction can hit a king by like symmetricity of this move. I need to iterate over directions, and one way would be to hard code something or have like 8 for loops. Instead, I will iterate over delta in rows and delta in columns that each can be from -1 to 1. And this combination of delta in one dimension and the other will give me a direction. I'm not interested in a direction that just changes both coordinates by 0. So if d1 and d2 are both 0, then continue. But otherwise, starting from a king, I want to keep moving in this direction. Say row is the first coordinate, I don't really care which one is which. King of 0 and col is king of 1. Do row plus equal d1, col plus equal d2. And now while inside of row col and not taken of row col. Function inside should check if everything is inside the chessboard. It's 8x8, so both coordinates needs to be from 0 to 7. Yes, we do. Now for array taken, I can either make it as two-dimensional array, 8x8, or I could convert queens into a set and then check if row call belongs to this set. Let's go with the maybe faster approach if there are more queens. That will always work in 64. I will not create a set that would be log. An ordered set would be a bit slower in general. I will create two-dimensional vector of Boolean values taken, 8x8. If inside of row call, it means that the other condition failed, that I stopped because this cell is taken by something, so by a queen. And then I will say, answer append, which is n place back for pairs, row call. I need to first create this thing to return. Oh, it's not pairs, it's vectors because of the format. I call that answer. So I will say pushback. Eventually I need to return. Let's run code. Something is wrong with brackets. The statement said that I can return in any order and it's accepted. The next problem is dice roll simulation, where we need to count sequences where every element is a number from 1 to 6, and for every number from 1 to 6, we know how many times in a row it can appear at most. We are given a sequence of size 6, and the fact that the fifth number is 2, it means 5 can appear at most 2 times in a row, but not 3 times. This is forbidden. But after 2 fives, there can be some other numbers, and then again, 1 5 or 2 fives, and so on. For given conditions and the length of sequence n, we need to count those satisfying the conditions, and n can be up to 5,000. Number of times in a row is very small, it's up to 15. So we can have a solution that works in complexity of n times 15 times maybe something else, but I will show you also just a linear approach. Because of small constraints and the fact that we need to count sequences, my first thought here would be dynamic programming. And in dynamic programming, I always ask for some prefix after we already chose this prefix, what is important to know how we can continue this sequence to the right? And here it's important what is the last number, say 3, and how many times it occurred. Maybe like here and there, which is 4 occurrences of 3 in a row. Then if 4 is still strictly smaller than the condition for 3, we can continue with 3. And for sure we can continue with every other number. This would mean that we have dp of length, say I, the prefix length, the number from 1 to 6, and the number of occurrences, say count, and this is our first dp. The thing is that a lot of dimensions is hard to follow, so I will get rid of this last condition, and instead I will say that the last number matters, f3, but now I want to put some other number, say f5 or whatever, maybe a lot of 5s. So I will iterate over the last interval of the same numbers, and I will say that then the next number must be something else. This way I get rid of this count of how many times the last number occurred in a row, because I know the next number will be different. And by iterating over every possible length of that interval of same numbers, I consider all the scenarios, how many times it will occur in a row. I saved the value of modulo and created a function that is very useful in dp, because to one number I want to add the other and also remember about modulo, so I will keep using this add self. I created dp, two-dimensional array dp n times 6, maybe instead of dp let's call it ways. It will be ways to fill some prefix and such that this is the last number. I need to in some way initialize that, and for every number the first interval of those can be up to the allowed thing, then or count from 1 up to roll max of a, ways of len a plus plus. There is a possibility that exactly this is prefix, like we have 5 threes in a row. Maybe here I will change that to minimum of n and roll max, just in case. Maybe roll max can be bigger than n. Can n be 0, by the way? It cannot. Now we initialized it. In C++, vector by default is filled with 0, so every other cell is 0. Now I need some transitions. I will iterate over states. I will be number that I choose now. Actually, 0 is not needed, because I already considered intervals that start exactly from 0. And the previous number from 0 to 6. And now a new number, if previous is equal next continue, this is forbidden. And for the number of times this new number occurs, up to roll max of next, I will do add self ways of I plus len.
My apologies.
Next.
I don't understand.
Add self ways of I plus len next to ways of I and previous. Here again, I need some minimum maybe. Let's move this the left a bit, I plus len smaller equal n. Not to get out of the array, then answer is 0, the last number can be whatever, so I will take the sum, add self, answer, ways of n a. This is the number of ways to choose sequence for prefix of size n, such that the last number is a, then return answer. It worked for the sample test. So I hope it will work in general. Yes, it's accepted. I said that I will show you a way to avoid that element 15 in the complexity. I don't want to here iterate over the size of interval. Instead, it will be just O of n times constant from 6. Well, this 15 is also a constant, but we want to solve problem also if roll max of I is up to n, and still do that in O of n. The current complexity instead is O of n times roll max times some polynomial of 6. How to improve it? Instead of here iterating over the length of next interval, let's first switch this a little bit and iterate over length of previous interval. That is, where I'm here, I iterated over I and let's say next. I want to compute or update ways of I next. And for that, here I will say add self ways of I next to ways of I minus len previous. And then len will be that, and I need a condition I minus len greater equal 0. That should, I hope, still work. And the thing is, this can be speed up with prefix sums. It doesn't work, output is 4. Why it doesn't? Because I need to iterate up to n. Now it does work, so let's submit. It's accepted. And how to get rid of this iteration? With prefix sums. Because here what happens is I iterate with len from 1 to some value, here up to 15, and I take the sum over ways, say ways of 10 and 0, ways of 90, ways of 80, and so on. And something like that. If you, while you go through DP, you update prefix sums of the same DP, you can just ask for that in constant time, and this way the for loop here is optimized to constant operation, but you get double the memory, because instead of just ways, you also have ways prefix sum. Actually, usually you can just pack it into one array, but it's unnecessary and leads to mistakes. The last problem is maximum equal frequency, where for a sequence of numbers, let's say this is the sequence, we want to find longest prefix, the answer turns out to be 7, such that we can remove one number so that all other numbers would occur the same number of times. It is possible to remove exactly one element from this prefix so that every number that has appeared in it will have the same number of occurrences. And here we remove 5. When we need to find longest possible something, like prefix, you can think about binary search, but it's not a way to go here because it's not monotonic. It is possible that some prefix will be good, like prefix of length 1 is good, then some prefix will be not good, say 3, 3, 3, 3, this is not good, but if you add one more 2, now you can remove 3. You can binary search only if for some prefix property, for some prefixes property from the statement that you're looking for holds true, and then it doesn't, or the other way around. If it jumps like true, false, you cannot binary search. What else can we do? We care about frequencies, so we can go from left to right and keep the array of frequency and do something with that. If we know that frequencies of numbers in some prefix are, say, 3, 3, and 4, then we know by removing one number, we basically decrease one frequency by 1. So this is 3. Also, what is possible, and I think this example shows it, is that if we had here frequencies for the prefix, number 1 appears 2 times, number 2 appears 2 times, 3 2 times, and 5 appears once, we can remove a 1, and if all other numbers are same, then we're good. So it's about analyzing cases, and actually, even if you're good, it's very easy to miss something. So I will implement what I see, what cases I see, and then think that maybe I missed something, maybe examples will show me that. For sure, I need frequency array. Let's iterate over elements from 0 to n minus 1. If something, then answer is I plus 1. If I end at index I, then the length of prefix is I plus 1. At the end, I will return answer. And what happens here? I need to update the frequency array. Let's use a map. A map should be fine. I could also, it would be a bit faster with array of size max element, but let's go with map that also is more Python friendly. You can easily use a dictionary here. This will be frequency. And if I here say plus plus frequency of AI, nums I, then I need to do some smart check. This might be quite hard to understand, but I decided to go with also array of frequencies. That is, if I know that something occurs twice, I want to increase by 1 the number of times I get number 2 in this. I'm interested in frequencies in this new array. The array of frequencies. Let's call that freq. Before I increase the number of frequencies, I will say if frequencies of, let's call this the current number x. If frequency of x is greater than 0, then minus minus frequency of frequencies, not frequencies of x, then plus plus that, and now plus plus frequency of frequency. This is very stupid looking line, but should do the job. First of all, if frequency size is big, greater than 2, I would say even, then we cannot do anything. Because by decreasing one number by 1, we will just modify one number. If the array is, for example, of frequencies 2, 2, 2, 2, 5, 5, and 1, then by modifying one element, I will still have two different numbers here. At least two different numbers. So then that's impossible. I will say only if that is smart equal to, then I have a chance. and what are possibilities. Let's cover a case like 5555551. Maybe first, can I not remove an element such that it is possible to remove exactly one element? Okay, if it was at most one element, it would be different. If it is something like 3333, then it's not good. If freak size is exactly one, then if the numbers are one, we're good. Let's remember what happens. We have a sequence, this freak. It represents a sequence of numbers, and I want to decrease one of them by one in order to make all of them equal. But if there is one, then it becomes zero. How to check just any number? I can use begin. This number, well, no, that I can decrease by one, and how many times it occurs? P dot first. If this is number one, awk is true, otherwise not awk, flag. Because this means going from 111 to just 11. I can make all numbers equal. Let's call the second pair q. Our begin gives me the first iterator from the end. And now either there is something like 5551, p first is 1, and it occurs just once, then awk is true. And what else do we have? We have a possibility like 54444. And that is if p first plus 1 is equal q first, and p second, q second, the number of times bigger number appears is just 1, then awk is true. And I keep using awk instead of flag. So that's what I came up with, which is quite ugly, but well, I won't always come up with the best possible code. There is something wrong here. Expected 13, let's see. Up to 13, we have that, so the whole sequence is good. The whole sequence should have frequencies 3, 3, 3, 3, and 1. And that should be covered by this case, in my opinion. Okay, I know the issue. The issue is that here maybe this becomes 0. So if that's the case, I want to remove it from the map completely. If this is 0, then remove. That's just some C++ thing. Now this map contains only numbers that do appear. Wrong answer for 11. I think that this should be covered by this case. If p first, then flag is true. Oh, this is just a 2. So there is one more case that is something like just a 5. If p second is 1, then also flag is true. There is just one number that occurs some number of times, and that's it. It's accepted. I got quite ugly code, I must say, here. And then, of course, if you do Leetcode, you should go to the forum and see somebody's short solution. So don't treat my code as something that is best possible. That's something that comes from logic that I explained to you. And it's perfectly normal that there can be something better. And here somebody found, wrote down cases. All elements appear exactly once, blah, blah, blah. And in Python, it can be written very nicely. Though also something like this is like a hack that is hard to get, where instead of storing all the frequencies, he just remembered the maximum frequency, max f, and from that he figured that all the cases can be checked. This is something more tricky, leads to shorter code, but not necessarily you will always come up with that. Just make sure that your logic covers the cases. So that was 3 problems with me today. Let me know in the comments if you like this format, or maybe there should be a separate video for every problem. And see you next time. Bye. Oh, and my codes are in GitHub repository, link in the description.